إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالًا كثيرًا ونساءً، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أيها الإخوة المسلمون، brothers and sisters in Islam, when you make wudu, you have an intention that you're making wudu. You go to the bathroom and you make sure that you cleaned up yourself, and you wash your hands, and you do the madmada and the nose and the face, the hands, and the wiping on the head with the ears, and then the feet. Then you made wudu. Then you are in a state of ritual impurity. With that, you can perform salah. There are things which, if it happens to you, then your wudu is no longer valid. They call them نواقض الوضوء, the nullifiers of wudu, things which would turn you back from the state of ritual purity to a state of ritual impurity. Likewise, when you become a Muslim, there are certain things, if you believe, certain things if you say, certain things if you do, actions yani, it actually can take you out of the fold of Islam. It becomes a nullifier of your Islam. But be careful, if you do it with knowledge, knowingly, and with a willful intention, العلم والقصد, both. How do you become a Muslim to begin with? And I know this is ABC for some of you, but let's explore that. The scholars, they say a person becomes a Muslim إما بالتبعية وإما بالقول وإما بالفعل. You become a Muslim by succession. Basically, you're born into a Muslim family. And alhamdulillah, they enhanced your fitrah, because everyone is born a Muslim. So they enhanced your fitrah and they kept you a Muslim. So you're a Muslim بالتبعيه, because of your parents. Or if the parents taken away or diverted you from the state of Islam and they turned you into a Christian or a Jew and you want to revert, then you come and say in front of the Muslim community, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. That's two. Or you tell me that you're a Muslim, that you declare that you're a Muslim. So this is two. Three, through your action, I see you, mashallah, in Jumu'ah. I have no doubt that you're in a Muslim. I see you observing the Salah. Then you're a Muslim. So that state, how do you come out of it? The scholars mention three things, brothers and sisters in Islam. Number one, bil juhud. Number two, bil istihlal. Number three, you commit a naqid, a nullifier, like the wudu thing. What is al-juhud? But again, you have to understand everything that I'm about to say, that when you do this with knowledge and willful intention, if the person is ignorant of what he is doing, he is still a Muslim and he is being excused by the lack of knowledge, or the scholars, they call it al-udhru bil-jahli. Or he's doing it out of error or out of forgetfulness, which would negate the willful intention. What is al-juhud? That you reject what is known from the religion by necessity. هو أن ترد الأمر ترد ما هو معلوم من الدين بالضرورة. Everyone knows as a Muslim that we have to pray 5 times a day, and then you come and say no, we don't have to do that. So you rejected the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. هذا هو الجحود. That you're commanded to do something and you reject it. You say no to it. I'm not going to do it. Again, brothers and sisters in Islam, with a willful intention and with knowledge, that will take that person out of the fold of Islam. He's no longer a Muslim. And who did this? The leader, Satan. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded him to bow down to Adam, he said, no, I'm not going to do it. He rejected the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is a big issue, brothers and sisters in Islam, that you reject the commands of Allah. You see, there is a difference between being unable to perform the act and saying no to the act. And this is how they differentiated. We know that the debate amongst the imams, whether al-Ahnaf or al-Shafi'iyya or al-Malikiyya or al-Hanabila, regarding the ruling on the person who does not pray. Of course, al-Hanabila, they said, yakfur. He's yakhruj min al-millah. He's not a Muslim. If someone who does not pray, even out of laziness, even if he's lazy. Why? Because salah is one of the acts which is known from the religion by necessity. What do you mean you're lazy? You can pray 5 times a day. And quite frankly, brothers and sisters in Islam, even though the school of thought of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal is the only one who ruled that, but they have legitimate evidence. في السنة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم says, العهد الذي بيننا وبينهم الصلاة. The covenant between جماعة المسلمين and this individual who does not pray is a salah. فمن تركها فقد كفر. هذا نص. Whoever turns away from performing the salah, yakfur. But the school of thought of Imam Abi Hanifa, rahimallahu al-jami', wal-Malikiyya wal-Shafi'iyya, they differentiated. They said, bring two individuals in front of you, and the two of them do not pray. and ask this one, brother, how come you don't pray? And he tells you, why should I pray? We live in America, man, we're busy. Five times, that's too much. People at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they had a lot of time in their hands. If he knows, and if he has that willful intention, يخرج من الملة, he goes out of the fold of Islam. Why? Because he's rejecting the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But look at the other one. Brother, how come you do not pray? Astaghfirullah ya Sheikh, make dua for me. Wallahi, I've been trying, it's just difficult. Astaghfirullah, can you please make dua for me, ya Sheikh, that I keep up with the... Hada Muslim. This is Muslim, because he did not reject the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He did not perform the act of juhud. What is the act of juhud? Which takes a Muslim out of the fold of Islam. So this is the first thing that you could do, and it would take that person out of the fold of Islam. Here is the second one, which is really the cornerstone of my khutbah today, is to make halal the haram. I will borrow the term my brother Okasha introduced, halalization, making halal, halalizing something that is haram and is known to be haram, and you turn it and you say about it, it's halal. Brothers and sisters in Islam, to begin with, the only one who can say to something is halal, something is haram, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one else is entitled to this premise except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed it in the revelation. And this is why في حديث النعمان بن بشير رضي الله عنهما, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم says, الحلال بين والحرام بين. You know what بين is? بائن يعني. Crystal clear. Why? Because you have an evidence. You have a Quran or authentic sunnah that states that this thing is halal or this thing is haram. Now, for you to say this is halal or this is haram, you have to have that evidence in hand. And you cannot come to a gray area and say it's halal. You can't. ولذلك, look at the wara. And the wara is the extra consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One level above taqwa, that all the imams, la'imma al-a'lam, they will never say to something in the gray area it's halal or haram. They will never say that. They will say, they will use this, yajuz, yajuz, it's permissible. Ara hadha, I think it's okay to do it. It's disliked, but he will never say to a gray area matter halal or haram. Why? Because who legislates the halal and the haram? Allah. شوف هذه الآية في سورة الأنعام. This verse in سورة الأنعام. قل أرأيتم ما أنزل الله لكم من رزق فجعلتم منه حراما وحلالا قل الله أذن لكم أم على الله تفترون. You see that provision which Allah brought down for you subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then you label this one to be halal and this one to be haram. Did Allah give you a permission to do this, or you're uttering a lie against Allah? What is it? ولا تقولوا لما تصف ألسنتكم الكذب هذا حلال وهذا حرام لتفتروا على الله الكذب. Do not utter a lie against Allah because you don't have an evidence to make something halal. Now, that gives you a picture regarding someone who does not say to something in the gray area to be halal. لا, He goes to something that is haram and he says it's halal. That's why he goes out of the fold of Islam. Again, those two restrictions, with knowledge and willful intention. Why I'm saying this? So we don't go around and call people kuffar. We can do that. We cannot do that. You have to remove those two. You have to make sure that he is not ignorant. You have to make sure that he is not led by a faulty interpretation. You have to make sure that he did not do this out of error or out of forgetfulness, or he is not forced to do it. You have to remove that from the picture completely before you label an individual to be a non-Muslim who was a Muslim before. Now, the reason for this, and I know this is not going to be favored by a lot of you, and you know, I'm very unpopular because of that, but alhamdulillah, I'm okay. I was asked a question by a family in Canada about the ruling on mortgage. You take a loan from a bank to buy a house. What is the ruling in home mortgage? I said it's haram. There is no question about it. A, B, C usury, riba, that I take a dollar from you and I give it back to you a dollar and a half, or a dollar and a cent, or a dollar or any benefit. The shuf, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, أَيُّ قَرْضٍ جَرَّ مَنْفَعَ فَهُوَ رِبَى. Like if I give you $100 and you return it with $100 and a thawb, usury. Usury, yeah. Give me the $100 now and bring the thawb an hour later. I'll take it. But not together. Usury. You're taking money from, wallahi ya ikhwa, as if the reaction, you cannot imagine the emails, the people, and as if I said to something that is haram, halal, or something that is halal, haram. Is to that extent, I understand that there are some scholars whom we love, whom we respect. They've fallen into that trap and they said halal, halal, halal. But based on what? Based on what? قال صلى الله عليه وسلم لعن الله الربا. Allah curses usury. وآكلة, the one who receives it, meaning the bank. وموكلة, the one who pays it, the one who feeds it. وكاتبة, the one who writes the contract, the real estate agent, to say the least. وشاهدي, and anyone who gets involved by witnessing this. Look, some of you may say, maybe the first one is the beneficiary really, but the rest are, you know, getting a little piece of the cake. كلهم سواء. All of them are alike. أنت هتخلي ده حلال إزاي يعني? How are you going to make this halal with that text? We said ABC. The scholars, they say there are two types of riba. Riba al-fadl wa riba al-nasi'ah. What is riba al-fadl? That I take a dollar from you, I give it back to you a dollar and a cent, like I explained earlier. Riba al-nasi'ah has to do with commodities. Exchange of commodities with some discrepancies according to the Sharia. It's not my son. That's ABC riba. Now it's haram based on that text. And based on other texts, it's haram. Ya ikhwal, Imam Malik, and this is a very interesting story. Someone in Medina got high. He got drunk. It was the night of the 15th of Ramadan. The night of the 15th of the month. I'm still thinking about Ramadan here. So you know, when the moon is full moon, the guy is high. So he's jumping up and down, thinking that he can catch the moon. He thinks that he can catch the moon. The moon is too close. The man was watching him, he said what? He couldn't believe. He knew that he's drunk. He said, "Imra'ati taliqun minni. In kana fil Islami kabira a'zamu min al-khamr." I divorce my wife if there is a major sin in Islam greater than intoxications, liquor. So of course he has to figure out what is the greatest sin in Islam. So he went to Imam Malik. He said, "Ya Imam, I said this is anzirni. Let me go back and check." 3 days in a row, he came back to him and he said to him, "Imra'atuka taliqun mink. Your wife is divorced. فَإِنِّي تَدَبَّرْتُ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ. I reflected upon the sunnah, upon the book of Allah, وَسُنَّةَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ, and the sunnah of the messenger of Allah. مَا وَجَدْتُ كَبِيرَةً أَعْظَمَ مِنَ الرِّبَى. I have not found a sin greater in the sight of Allah than usury." What do you mean, halal? That you go and take this, and ya ikhwa, they come back with this fiqh rule, which is legitimate. Fiqh rules are certain lines which the scholars use to derive verdicts and religious rulings. The most famous of them is called al-darurat تبيح المحظورات. الضرورة, the necessity, makes permissible. It doesn't make halal again. We go back. تبيح, من الإباح. تبيح, it doesn't make halal. لا, makes permissible the forbidden. ربا is forbidden. Now, dealing in usury, you must have ضرورة, necessity. Now, the jurists, the fuqaha, defined what is a darura in the sharia. Ma hiya darura fi sharia? What is the darura? What? Madhannatul halaka. Hadhihi ad-darura. That you will perish if you do not do this act. You will be homeless if you do not do this act. Let's go with food. You're traveling in the desert. You're dying from thirst. You're about to die. By all the sudden, you spotted a bottle of wine. Don't they dream here? For you to save your life is to take a drink. Take it. But take enough that survives, that makes you survive, yeah. Survival, yeah. But don't drink the whole bottle. Take enough. Heavy. Apply this to the housing. What is going on with rental? You're going to be homeless? What is going on with rental? Here is what you hear from the brothers. But Sheikh, rentals, you know, you can't use this for taxes, and we waste our money, and the guy who gives us the house, so what? So what? Don't you want to go to Jannah? Is Jannah cheap for you? Pay for Jannah, ya akhi. Pay for Jannah. Who given you that money to begin with? Allah given it to you. Pay for Jannah. Pay to be in the halal. I don't care if he deals with usury himself, if he is benefiting from you. I'm a Muslim, I can deal. Rental is halal for me. But purchasing this house is haram for me. Now I'm gonna pay those $2,000 to get to Jannah. إِنَّ اللَّهَ اشْتَرَى مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَمْوَالَهُمْ بِأَنَّ لَهُمُ الْجَنَّةِ. For you to get, in أَلَا إِنَّ سِلْعَةَ اللَّهِ غَالِيَةِ. Indeed, the commodity of Allah is expensive. أَلَا إِنَّ سِلْعَةَ اللَّهِ هِيَ الْجَنَّةِ. The commodity of Allah is al-Jannah. Wouldn't you like to pay to see Allah? Wouldn't you like to pay to see Rasulullah? Fil Jannah. And who's giving you the money for rental to begin with? Allah. You made this money on your own. Allah giving it to you. Pay it to be in the halal. For you to understand what I'm trying to say, let's assume that you and your wife are separated geographically. You live in the US and your wife lives in Egypt. I'm using Egypt because nothing personal. Now we read the text that a woman cannot travel by herself without a mahram. The hadith هذا صحيح. Hadith ibn Abbas في البخاري. Imagine Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم when he said this, a woman should not travel the distance of one night by herself. A man stood up, Ya Rasulullah, my wife is going for Hajj and I signed up my name to do jihad with you in this battle. Leave the jihad and go with your wife. عندك يعني انت عايز دليل اكثر من هذا؟ يجي يقول لك ما هو good company، هذا تعليل، والتعليل في مكان الدليل عليل. يقول لك تعليل using logic when you have an evidence is a sick way of dealing with the text. فhere is the thing that I'm trying to come across here. Now you want your wife to come to live with you, then you go and book her a ticket. Why not you book in a ticket and go and pick her up and come back with her to be in the halal? Allah gave you the money, do it. So what? Add to this, brothers and sisters in Islam, quite frankly, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about the bounty of having a home, you know what he said? وَاللَّهُ جَعَلَ لَكُم مِّن بُيُوتِكُمْ سَكَنًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made for you houses, homes, where you find sakan. What is sakan? Peace, tranquility, طُمَأْنِينَ, happiness. The one thing that we're all after. Who is the source of this? Answer me. That state of the heart is in the hands of Allah. Allah can make you fear. Allah can make you anxious. سَنُلْقِي فِي قُلُوبِ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا الرُّعْبِ. Imagine this. We will cast into the hearts of the disbelievers terror. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the source of that second, of that peace, of that tranquility. How did you get that house? I'm not saying you, but I'm talking about a person who got that house through mortgage, through the haram way. So you got it through the disobedience of Allah. You think Allah is going to do this to you? They're not only this. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أُوِيهِ بُلِيْهِ اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَذَرُوا مَا بَقِيَ مِنَ الرِّبَى إِن كُنْتُم مُؤْمِنِينَ. Fear Allah and leave off usury. If you're believers, فَإِن لَمْ تَفْعَلُوا, what if you don't do, فَأْذَنُوا بِحَرْبٍ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. So Allah is the one who's supposed to give you peace and tranquility is at war with you because of this house. لذلك يا إخوة, والله والله I tell it and we hear it all the time as imams. Fancy بيوت فارهة, fancy homes, but look at the people inside it, fighting all the time, sick all the time. Sometimes you live in a small halal place, but it's lawful, brings you happiness, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make you happy with it. You making, you see, brothers, no doubt in my mind that a lot of us are indulged in this now. But my message today, don't ever see this halal. Don't. Because it's haram. And the funny thing about this thing is, that person who followed the fatwa, the verdict of one of the scholars maybe 10-15 years ago, and he already is living in a house out of mortgage, he still asks. The moment that he sees another person who claims knowledge, Is it halal or haram? You're already doing it. Why are you asking? Why are you asking? Because it still feels funny. Al-ithmu ma haka fi al-sadri wa khashita an yattali' alayhi an-nas walau aftawka. Sin is something that aches. I feel funny about it. Even if they give you fatwa, one. Even if they give you fatwa, two. Even if they give you fatwa, three. Still funny. There is a difference between you being engaged in a sin, brothers and sisters in Islam, and feeling it's halal. Thinking it's halal. And a difference between you're indulged in a sin, in committing a certain sin, and you know it's haram. Because you know that thing haram, you know it's haram, this will be the mobilizing force for you to come out of it. But if you see it halal, how are you going to come out of it? You see, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam spoke about tawbah, he mentioned certain conditions. And one of these conditions is regretfulness. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم الندم هو التوبة. The act of regretting what you have done is the cornerstone of the act of repentance. Why? Because you look at it as a sin, but if you don't see it as a sin, how are you going to regret it? Technically, you're not going to come out of the sin, brothers and sisters in Islam. The second thing which a person may find himself out of the fold of Islam, if he does this knowingly with a willful intention that you name something which is haram to be halal, and you believe in that, this can take you out of the fold of Islam. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه أمهات المؤمنين وعلى من اتبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. Brothers and sisters in Islam, and I hope the brothers, the Hindu back community doesn't go at me. I'm actually praising. You know why the Muslim community in America found a solution for the meat? Why? Because of the followers of the school of thought of Imam Abi Hanifa rahimahullah, which is the Hindu back community mainly. You would ask a brother, and I'm not trying to ridicule or make you laugh, but this is the reality. Brother, do you smoke? Yeah. Do you drink? Yeah, sometimes. Do you eat meat that is not dhabiha? Astaghfirullah. Can do that. That's why we have all these halal stores in America. I was landing in Newark, New Jersey airport. Subhanallah, I thought, halal! At the airport, halal! It's Allahu Akbar. You go to Costco now, and you go to Moscow and Basco, and halal. Why? You forced your will as a community. What went wrong with the subject of owning homes? You see, I don't want to sit here and just, you know, throw a theory at you and send you home with it. We gotta think of solutions for this. What thrown you us off on this subject? That you got some jurists making it easy. Yeah, do it. It's okay as long as the house is not for investment. Is it your first or second house? First or second house? Oh, the second house. Oh, riba. But the first house, it's okay. What do you mean? If it is riba here, it's riba here. So, and some brothers say, America. We live in America, Sheikh. Yasidi, you want to tell me that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in his eternal knowledge, did not know that your excellency is gonna take a flight from your country to America and you're gonna decide to live here. Now you have to stretch Islam, get rid of Islam for you to live here. Why not establish Islam here? We have children. You see, in some years we'll leave. What about your kids? Why not establish Islam here? I'll give you a good scenario here, very, very interesting scenario. You know, they've been saying for the last 20 years that the number of Muslims in America is 8 million. It's so amazing, never increases. But I tell you right now, at least we have 20 to 25 million Muslims living in the United States. So imagine this, just let's get 10 million out of those and work together. And each one of them places a dollar in a fund every day, a dollar a day. That is $10 million a day. A month, $300,000. A year, you do the math. Did we solve the problem or no? But it takes what now? Com.com unity. Community. Togetherness. That is why Iyyaka Na'budu. We're going to solve the problem. The problem can be solved. The same thing with insurance. The same thing with anything that we have. But brothers and sisters in Islam, until this happens, please, if you are into that sin, it is a sin and it is a major sin. See it as sin. Don't make it halal, please. I love you, Wallahi. Wallahi, I said this. I know this subject doesn't make me very popular, and I'm fine with that. But Wallahi, because I care. Because I care. See it as a sin. That's my message today. Listen, I'm not asking you to break your financials and... No, nobody will say that. But the moment that you see it as a sin, and you intend in your heart that you want to come out of that sin, Wallahi, Allah will make the means for you to come out of it. But as long as you're dwelling on the idea that this is halal, there is no way this is will happen. The third thing, brothers and sisters in Islam, in closing, which will take a Muslim out of the fold of Islam, is coming up with a nullifier. So committing shirk, engaging in hasad and sihr, I'm sorry, and so forth, inshaAllah. فنسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يعني عصمنا من الكبائر يا رب العالمين. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us all from the major sins. Above all, ya ikhwa, this particular sin which, you know, invites Allah's anger and Allah's war with you. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يوفقنا إلى ما يحب ويرضى. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن ينقي كسبنا من الحرام يا رب العالمين. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر دينك وسنة نبيك وعبادك المؤمنين. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. Just a quick announcement. Alhamdulillah, جزاكم الله خيرا. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward every brother and sister who helped us throughout the month of Ramadan. The $75,000 check went out yesterday, the second payment for this year for this facility, inshallah. جزاكم الله خيرا. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless your wealth. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم.